beautiful souls. My name is Anoshi Asta, and this recording is actually made for the Heaven on Earth podcast, but I also wanted to do this a video version of this, so I wanted to introduce my special guest for you. So this content is for episode number 13, and you can listen to the podcast at anoshiasta.com/podcast and find all the show notes and downloadable links right there. So today I really have a special guest on this podcast. Her name is Krista Raisa. She is an accomplished psychic medium, a multidimensional channel. She channels the Orion Council. She's an author of several books, and her latest book is called Starseed Survival. And today we will really talk about what it means to be a starseed, and also how can you know whether you're a starseed, and when you discover yourself to be connected with your origin to be from the stars, then how can you manage this physical life being a starseed? So Krista will give us tools and share some insight on how, as a starseed, we can survive this planet Earth, this heavy dimensional planet Earth that can be created into heaven on Earth, of course. But so I've mentioned many times in my show how Atlanteans work side by side with aliens, Pleiadians. I have a very personal memories from working with Pleiadians, and I've also had memories of living in the Pleiades, and I've created a video about that as well, and I talk about it in my podcast. And they are benevolent beings that are here to support us. So we will talk about, of course, the Pleiadians, the Orions, the Sirians a little bit, but mainly the focus is going to be on being a starseed and giving you some ascension tips. So Krista will channel a live Orion Council message for us in this podcast episode. So thank you so much for listening, and let's get started. So aloha, beautiful souls, and welcome to episode number 13. Today, I have a very special guest on this podcast, and we will be talking about, talking to all of you starseeds out there. Really, you will have some beautiful starseed survival tips that my special guest will be, and I will be talking about, and we'll also be talking about the Orion Council and some of those high vibrational, benevolent star beings that are here to help us. So this is going to be a very exciting episode. In several episodes, I have mentioned how during the ancient Atlantis, the Atlantean, golden Atlantean times, star beings were a part of our everyday life, and many of them lived among us. They are among us today too, but not as openly. Well, we'll talk about that. We'll see what the special guest has, the expert on this matter, has to say. And you may be from the stars as well. So let me introduce my guest to you, and then we can get started with this. And I have personally known this guest for many, many years, and I've always loved and admired her free spirit. So it's Krista Raisa. She's an accomplished psychic medium, multidimensional channel, intuitive artist, spiritual teacher, and healer. She is well known internationally, thanks in large part to her success as a YouTube sensation. She channels on YouTube, she shares starseed tips, and channels the Orion Council. And she is the author of several books, including her latest, Starseed Survival, which is largely the topic we will be discussing today. She will, at the end of this interview, she will also channel a message directly from the Orion Council. So that's gonna be super exciting, a very special treat for us. I can't wait to hear what they have to say. So let's give her a warm welcome to Heaven on Earth. Hello, Krista.
Hello, everyone. Hope you're having a good ascension. 2017 is here. 2017. Wow, Krista, isn't this how are you feeling this year? Now that you mentioned ascension.
I'm laughing because it's very important when things are happening economically and politically, religiously around the world that make no sense to a lot of people. And sometimes it just helps to laugh, which is part of the amazing teachings that these beings have given me through me to humanity with amazing wisdom. And as you all know, the Orion constellation has had many experiences similar to that as Star Wars, which many may have seen quite recently, Rogue One. And there were actually some amphibious looking characters in there. So that's exciting to see beings that kind of look like Orion Council in the media. So it's all being revealed now. It's fun times.
Can you share more about that? That's really exciting to hear.
The being was called Admiral Radduck in the original, and so his descendants were in this version. And so Anu and I were just talking about concepts in Finnish, and that's something Orion Council wanted me to talk about today. In meditation, they were speaking of concepts, and quite often we don't really agree on something. And Finnish writers, scientific writers, have said that it's not real unless it's a fact. And a fact happens when more people agree on a phenomena. And so if five people in the room are seeing the same being, hopefully angelic, then they can all agree this happened to all of us. And so the point of us sharing here is so we can kind of match up our experience and say, hey, what's real now? And that's the whole idea behind my latest book, Starseed Survival. It's a very uncut version of reality with a beautiful, positive, balancing, healing message, ongoing message from Orion Council. So thank you for having me. I'm excited to channel for everyone on Angel Radio.
Yeah, I'm so excited to have you. And like I said, I just so admire your free spirit. And we will talk about that because you are a great example to anyone who is looking to be themselves, right? Live authentically and really live fully the inner wisdom. And I think every time I see you, I know that you're so 100% yourself, and that's what I love about you, and that's why I want to pick your brain, like I really want to talk about this. But you mentioned Finnish language. We were talking a little bit of Finnish before we get started, so many of my followers most likely know that I grew up in Finland, and then around 10 years ago I moved to here to California. But Krista, you were raised in New York City, but you also lived in Finland, and you have one parent is Finnish, is that correct?
Yep, dad is from Finland. He's from Karhula, which is now known as Kotka. So in English, that's like Bear Town and Eagle. Finnish names, often named after nature, location-wise. And yeah, I lived there for 10 years. I have citizenship there. I went to high school and university there. I had my spiritual awakening, found Anu's angel forums on the internet, so she was part of me waking up spiritually. And yeah, Finland has lots of old souls who have now been probably looking into folk medicines, healings, and they're very serious about their spirituality there. So it's really good supportive people in what we're doing, I feel.
Yeah, it's wonderful. And now you live in Arizona. Oh, by the way, the forum you mentioned, it's such a long time ago, isn't it? It feels like a long time ago that, and we used to have those forums. Now it's a lot of the groups are more, the conversations happen on Facebook. Facebook has taken over, but that was a fun time, and I'm so grateful to have been a part of your awakening journey. And so that's really neat.
Yeah,
How did you discover your how did you discover, how did you realize your star seed?
Yeah, I want to start off by saying one part of the multifaceted spiritual awakening experience, which was reading one of Doreen Virtue's books about like earth angels and types of spiritual servants, light workers, and one was star people. And I remember saying, okay, star people, they like to gaze and look at the stars. And I had this feeling like, yeah, that's me, but I never really looked at the stars. I just wanted to say that that's me. I don't know why I wanted to say that. And it sort of seeded an idea in my mind. And so after coming across books by these Pleiadian channelers, after the spiritual awakening, Barbara Marciniak, Christine Day, things just started changing, I feel, in the heart, because the Pleiadians are so, they've ascended already into fifth dimensional love frequency, and they're amazing guides for ascension and awakening. And I always felt like, okay, I won't need to know if I'm from Sirius or from the Pleiades, because I need to know this. And if not, it's fine, I'll just be an earth angel or however you call it, light worker. But I just had this burning need to know. I did get a reading with Lavendar from Starseed Hotline, and of course did my own research, had my own confirmations of it, and found out that I'm a Lyran-seeded Pleiadian, so I'm not from the Orion star system. I just work with a group that is from there to resolve Orion conflict on Earth, because they still have problems here. Many masterful beings from Orion are here, but some are still in the trenches, so to speak. So the council is actually, they're counseling groups of ETs, humans, and other people connect with Orion Council. But there's hundreds of councils of light. There's hundreds of them helping Earth right now. They are very eager. So I say, careful what you wish for, because they might just contact you if you want.
So, Krista, you mentioned Sirians, you mentioned Pleiadians, and the Orion star system, and then there the Lyrans, and so how, what are the differences? Do you have some information to share? Like, what, how can a listener right now to start maybe identifying with some of the star systems?
Sure. So some of the oldest beings in our local galaxy are the Lyrans, which you can say, oh, a Lyran looks like this Pleiadian looks like that. But so on the internet, you'll find a lot of cat-looking beings. But there are grays that have cat-like. There's many hybrids. There's just so many planets out there. But in our local galaxy, we have these main groups, one of the oldest being Lyrans, coming through somewhere, I want to say, between the 12th and 5th dimensions as light and sound, and then taking on physical form. It is more complicated than that, but that's like a basic rule of thumb I go by. And then they moved out into the galaxy, going to Sirius star system. And you had different sorts of evolution. Vega star system, very selfless, service to others. And then the service to self groups as well, which we can name probably a couple here on this planet. But overall, the star people have this awareness of life beyond this earth. And we can probably all agree on this show that it's obvious, but it's not so obvious to so many people. There are people who really feel uncomfortable with this idea and would rather, be like an ostrich and put the head in the sand, sorry to say, because it's easier that way. And we're just saying, look up into the sky and see for yourself. There's so much yet we have to uncover, and truths that will be revealed to humanity. We're
helping people to not be so afraid because they look a little different. So I know I went off topic there, but
yeah. So you talked about the vegans and the Lyrans. What would you say? I personally feel very, very connected to the Pleiadians. Pleiadians just naturally just feel, when we talk about different kind of aliens, I feel kindred spirit with many of them, but Pleiadians feel like home. But what would you describe Pleiadians and Sirians? Those are probably one of the most known. Are they also most abundant on Earth?
So we're not too far away from the Pleiades, and from my research, I found that there are people on our planet who have the means to visit the Pleiades, and it's sort of like a more restful vacation spot. There's one that's known on Earth. It's like a vacation spot where people wear these gray jumpsuits and they have the different flags on the emblems. And so they have this technology, which at some point will be revealed to Earth people. But there are many people who have been taken to the Pleiades, inventors, and they have a more, I would say, harmonious communication because the Pleiadians went through this interfering in the Orion conflict, and the Orions retaliated by blowing up one of the planets in the Pleiades. So the Pleiades are doing like a sort of loving interference now. They're not forcefully, maybe, you know, with respects to some renegade groups, but they're, in general, they're not like forceful. They're here to show the new way. And because they come from love and goodness, and so, you know, they used to think, oh, everyone's like that. Who wouldn't want our love and this healing energy? It's just the natural way of being. And so it's more of, okay, we're not here to convert them. We're here to be examples and help when they want our help. So it's sort of like a very general seven sister like mentality, as been documented by many Native American groups, the Cherokee, who say they come from there and
That's really, when you said about blowing up the Pleiadian planet, I almost burst into tears. It just really hit home. Yeah. And I felt it, I definitely felt it in my heart, and the compassion that followed in the Pleiadian, like the Pleiadians didn't go into revenge or that, on the contrary, clearly it was an ascension moment for them, even more so choosing love, and that's what they can teach us. Planet Earth lives in this revenge cycle so much, and it never brings peace, it never brings love. So the Pleiadians are beautiful guidance to finding new ways, new constructive ways to create a better world for us all. And the Native American, I've been doing past life regressions for many, many years, and taught past life regressionists, and it showed up a few times where I've guided someone to a Native American past life, and then a Pleiadian shows up. And it's really interesting because in those moments, the Pleiadians look very Native American, except they have white hair. But anytime I personally, when I want to channel Pleiadian energy, when I really want to feel Pleiadian, I put feathers in my hair. Somehow the feathers are, it's a Native American thing, it's a Pleiadian thing. But Pleiadians are also a very Atlantean thing, because they worked in Atlantis with us so much. What about the Sirians?
The Sirians, I was just processing the chills I got when you said that about the feathers. The Sirians, from what I've heard in the spiritual place called Sedona, where I live, maybe people heard of it, there's lots of spiritual people here, and space-oriented folks, who have said to me time and time again, the Sirians are very technological and science-y. And I thought, gee, how... you know, how is that? The people think that. And I read the tarot papers by Robert Morning Sky, who is Hopi Native American, and through oral tradition, he passed down a story of a contact story, which had a major part to in our Earth history, which was related to Sirius star system. And just to really generalize and simplify it, these beings, some call the Anunnaki or Nephilim, have a story of coming here through Hopi style as genetic engineers, master geneticists who knew all about DNA. And they came to this Earth planet. They called it Eridu or Eridu, which is very interesting because they have a lot of these stories in the Sumerian tablets. And it's funny that we're mentioning Finnish language because Finnish language has lots of words that are very similar to Sumerian. And do you know what is interesting? The being who was the father, the Syrian father, whose sons took rulership on Earth, according to this legend, the father's name was Anu. And then they said in the story that you had these beings called the Aku as well, which is a common Finnish name. It's the equivalent of Donald. You know, Aku Anka, Donald Duck in Finnish. So these loving angelic beings were long ago coupled with a more warlike race, and no judgment, they got together, and so they've created these offspring. And this is the story that repeats itself time and time again in the Bible, in the ancient Egyptian storyline, Cain and Abel. There are these two brothers who are constantly battling each other, and this battle took place in Sirius star system. But at the same time, I want to just say, because many people are wondering, are they from Sirius or Sirius B, because they've heard about cetaceans and whales and dolphins coming from there. So if you're an Atlantis lover or you've been there in a past life, you probably have an amazing connection with the cetaceans or ancient dream keepers. And a lot of their consciousness is held in Sirius star system. So that also may be a very loving connection there. It's not necessarily, you're an Anunnaki now. No, no, no. These are ancient legends, beautiful stories that just shows that something did happen long ago. And we may have memories of this in our DNA.
Yeah. Regression. And these stories repeat in virtually in all, like we find similarities in they repeat in different cultures and different mythologies, really. And it's so exciting when you start studying and you look two and two together, these ancient alien visitations and them helping shape this world into what it is today is everywhere. The evidence is everywhere, even though we don't have physical proof, but it's there in the myth. And where do myths start? They always start from something. Troy was a myth at some point, but now we know it's true. So it's a matter of time before most myths can be turned into when they will be revealed. But let me ask you something about being starseed. Now maybe the listeners have kind of had an idea of all these different star beings out there. So what does it really mean to be a starseed? Because we have these Pleiadians, Assyrians, Lyrans, they're all coming to visit us. When I say I'm a Pleiadian starseed, for example, it doesn't mean I'm a Pleiadian. Right? It means I'm a star. What does that mean? Where's the difference between us and the starseeds? I mean, them and the starseeds.
If you are identifying as a Pleiadian, you've probably done enough soul work, spiritual work to identify previous or simultaneous or future incarnations. I say that because time is different in these different galaxies. It's not the same as one Earth year. And so their whole system of counting, you know, for us maybe parallel reality, passive, it's hard to say in a linear sense, but we all have a soul. We all have a soul that's learned specific lessons. So yes, we're all from the same one creator, but we have individualized soul consciousness, which has had lessons. And if you have incarnated, let's say 30,000 Pleiadian cycles, and you've incarnated 5,000 cycles in Sirius, I would say, oh yes, I am more Pleiadian, just like we do genetic testing now to know our ancestry. You can say, well, you know, I don't really remember my life in Arcturus. You know, I only had 10 of them, maybe. So I don't really identify as one. Just like, well, if you visit China on vacation, does that make you Chinese? Probably not if that's not your family and your genetics, but maybe somewhere down the line. Of course, these concepts are so fluid now on our Earth that people are doing it because they feel like it. I say, hey, if that's what you feel like, you know, why not?
Could it also be that it's a civilization, it's a vibration where we most can learn from at this time?
Yeah, definitely. I feel it's for a reason. Mm-hmm. I'm not bringing in necessarily other universal energies because I'm focused in this galaxy. My consciousness, you know, it's not relevant for me to. So focusing on a Pleiadian consciousness would be relevant because of the teachings that come from there. Mm-hmm. Also, it is my deep knowing that they are sending information into our atmosphere, and this is etheric fifth dimensional information. And so those of us who open our upper chakras are more easily pulling in spiritual downloads, as in directions from these guides who are at such a high vibration we cannot see them, but they are there, like a ceiling fan that is spinning very quickly. It is still there, but you don't see the individuals that are perhaps working with you genetically on a spacecraft.
Yes.
It's very exciting.
Yeah, I've had some wild experiences in my meditations, for sure, with the Pleiadians, and only positive and enlightening and beautiful. So I want to ask, because somehow when we talk about aliens, there's still this collective, this group consciousness around us that makes you feel like, well, you believe in aliens, you think you're a star, you know, that energy, that programming, that those thoughts that make us feel ashamed of or cautious about expressing that part of ourselves. I'm wondering, where does that come from? Is that a part of why is there such a negative association for something so positive and so beautiful? And also, what are your tips for, you know, coming out of the starseed closet?
Yeah. That's my specialty. Okay. I love this question. Right. It is baffling, coming from a fifth dimensional perspective. Why would a being want to remain dense and pineal gland calcified and, you know, focused on the negative, horrible things? You know, I would love to say pop culture examples, but it's all coming out, especially if you look at these American reality TV shows. And so you just see the kind of, you know, the most unconscious of behavior. And I dare say there's a small group, you know, there's a small elite power group here who for some time were given power. But the Pleiadians know we're in this new golden age, and many other groups realize this as well as they wake up to this. A lot of us are working with groups who just have not had that experience. They've not had the experience of, oh, loving kindness and someone giving you a sandwich, or here, I thought of you, this is just for you. Maybe they were not embraced as children or had horrible past lives. You know, while showing the way, we're incarnated here, and so we are in these programmed vessels to a certain extent, dealing with pathogens and emotional disconnection. Because yes, there are groups that have not done such a great job running things here, and in order to bring about a new way, we must identify the problems in a loving, compassionate way, because these beings, of course, are looking to orient themselves in the golden age. So they may have, in essence, they may have not had a golden age experience, and so they're going, oh, what is gold? Like, what is heart chakra? I didn't know I had one. It's little things. I feel it's the little person who works in their studio, you know, painting the painting, and just one day at a time. And it's not necessarily, you know, big flags being waved in the sky. It's that little feeling you have. It might be a fairy on your shoulder. You see an angel, and your life is totally changed. Mm-hmm. And these can also be our ET star family, because they are so bright and so evolved and loving. They look to many as angels. So if you are having an unexplained experience, you may be working with archangels, which are in pure service. Using only divine will, God's will, to assist. And then you have angelic beings such as Pleiadian, evolved, loving, higher dimensional energies, and ascended masters who are here to just help when you ask. That's all we have to do, right?
Yeah.
So the ETs are like that too. They're just a little more commanding, I would say. They're a little more sassy, mm-hmm. in my opinion.
So how do you come out of that starseed closet? What was your journey? How did you make yourself known to the public that, hey, I channel Orion Council? I'm sure it wasn't like just super easy. I'm sure you went through some kind of a process, right?
I was already making a spiritual videos on YouTube. And it was I said in my friend Elina's house in Joensuu, which is in Western Finland, near Russian border. I was at her house, and if she wasn't home. I made a video next to her plants, and it said, "Well, I'm coming out with my beliefs." I said, in this very, very gentle, girly voice, and I was very frightened. But at that point, I didn't care anymore. I knew enough about what I was talking about. And I'd like to say I've been awake and aware of the spirit world for a long time, but they say awakening happens in cycles. So the major cycle with ETs actually came after the channeling. I wasn't convinced or sure that they were extraterrestrials speaking through me. I thought they were angels at first. A blue light in my head that I kept seeing. I thought they were in an angelic group. And that's it. It's just the consciousness. But surely enough, I channeled about amphibious beings communicating through me and ran into two psychics who saw them above my head in the eighth chakra. They said, yeah, they look like amphibious humanoids when you talk about the Orion Council, which makes a lot of sense. So I made a coming out video on YouTube, which I deleted.
How did that feel?
It felt liberating, and even though everything I do is like disclosure, just saying that I am a starseed, it's like I can imagine, you know, at the Alcoholics Anonymous, hi, my name's Bob. It's like that, like, mm-hmm. Yes, I am. Yeah. I am this. Just mm-hmm. saying that is enough.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's powerful. And liberating, like you said. And so You also, with this, you've gone through so much of this inner work and this process, and learned so much from the Orion Council, and you've made it into a wonderful spiritual career for yourself. You created a life purpose business where you channel, you sell books, and you create beautiful starseed items that inspire others, and you do so many things. I know that in your book, Starseed Survival, you also give some business advice, how to turn that inner passion into a career. Would you give some tips on how do you do it, and what would you say to anyone who is on that path?
Well, the first thing that comes to mind is we have our little secrets, right? We have our hidden experiences, we have our secret passions and thoughts. So when somebody is feeling like they're the only one in the room and you're scratching your head going, somebody needs to do something about this. Why don't they have, pencil cases with the Pleiades on it, just for instance. Why doesn't anyone make that? That's you. That's your divinely inspired thought.
I
And
love that
that's
idea. I
and Ollie, and Ollie.
Yes.
Which is Finnish for pencil case. That's really the age of Aquarius. If you have a good Aquarian friend, those are these idea people. Hey, when you look at horoscopes, the Aquarian one always says, "Hey, what about the aliens? Maybe they're right. Maybe it takes that little, just allowing yourself to dream, allowing, and then it just builds on itself. The idea. The maintained focus, the meditation practice, the healthy lifestyle, helping other people opens your heart chakra, and is open and vulnerable. As scary as that may be, you will find joy. You will find people, similar people, soul family. Oh my God, it just gets better.
Yes, definitely. And it feels wonderful being able to do the work you love and really being in that authentic, whatever it means, whether it means creating your own job or whether it means just coming out of the starseed closet to just be who you really are. Because once we take that leap of faith, hey, I'm gonna be safe. I'm safe even if I do this, even if I let my family know that I talk to aliens, or even if I tell my coworkers that, hey, I believe aliens exist. Even if you just take that, whatever step it is for you, it's so liberating, it's so freeing, and it creates blessings in so many ways, whether it is that career choice or just a personal journey.
And the honesty with yourself is a truthful energy that other people sense, so they feel it's they can speak with you and share with you because you're being real, whether they believe it or not. They get a what is there's a word for it. It's the trust. They trust in you more.
So being a star seed, many starseed people are very sensitive to earth energies and to this denser, because the planets are more evolved, so the energy is higher vibration than what it has been here on Earth. What are some of the sort of survival tips to be able to consume this food that we have here, to be able to go outside and not feel like you're attacked by these external energies? Because I know so many people who are starseed, they it's not easy. There's depression, there's all kinds of symptoms that come through when you don't know if you belong or it's just too much energy. What
One of those being loneliness too, that I spoke with a psychologist, and he talked about this isolation, which it's great for inner work and the unconscious, the spirit world, the nature, and it's always a balance. So even if you're working with your heart chakra and you're doing good things, there comes a time you might be pushed out of your comfort zone. God has given you gifts and abilities to use. And a lot of star people get anxiety because they're not able to, they're not allowing the light language to come through. Oh, you will see this. I have had channeling sessions. They're documented. They will be released soon. I can't say where, when, and where. But boy, it is a wrestle with our own egos as star people.
Mm.
Oh, that's so silly, Oh, well, my parents don't like tarot, so I might as well not, pull a relationship card for myself. No, pull a relationship card for yourself. Trust your instincts. Your intuition will guide you. There's been so many times, I have to say with the channeling has come social anxiety, but I'm so grateful for that sensitivity because there will be days I'm guided to go to Starbucks, or I'm guided to go, to the grocery store for no reason. It's very strange, hard to explain. But that's because my boyfriend needs to meet somebody. His soul family is there, and I'm the conduit because I'm so sensitive, and I'm running around doing things for people with no knowing of why, right? And it's a blessing, and it's also a great challenge to be self-directing, also trust in the universe, but trusting yourself that you're okay, I'm channeling something for me now, so is that really real? Am I really channeling? And in that case, I say, hey, work with a healer, get a psychic reading, call in on the radio show, write it out on Facebook, don't be scared, because 10 other people might have the same exact experience, you're not alone.
Community is important, and it is becoming more and more important as we are awakening more and more. We need each other, right? We need each other, and so that we don't isolate, so we don't feel lonely, and we get strength from each other. And that's a good way of that's a great tip. Do you have any other starseed survival tips you want to, like, last one that you want to throw out there that you have in your mind before we go into the channeling session?
Yes, crystals. The people who follow my work online, most of them are very much into crystals. So you can always give that as a gift to someone who just doesn't understand. You can protect yourself from EMFs with certain ones like shungite. It absorbs EMF. Russians have found this. And you can order these crystals on eBay, on Etsy, support handmade. Get your crystals. They might start talking to you. That's my last tip.
Oh, I love that. I love crystals. And I have some crystals from you as well when I've placed an order. Thank you so much. They're very, very precious to me. I love my crystals. And I do talk to them. I meditate with them. And they give me wisdom and strength and love. So that's a great, great tip. So are we ready to go and see what the Orion Council has in store for us? I'll give you a minute to tune in, and whenever you're ready.
So it is Run Council here. Hold on, please. It is nice to communicate. One moment. Thank you. We want to communicate about energetics on your planet Earth. It is nice to communicate. How are you? Orion Council here. How are you? Orion Council here.
Feeling wonderful, thank you.
Ah, that is good, because we are wanting to communicate, and what is happening now is we are having adjustments, and we are also wanting to give information, ask you a question, and sense the energetic shifting taking place between yourselves and the planet. Hold on, please. Everyone here is watching you, and as you know, it is a wonderful show on your planet. Thank you. We want you to know that as you are created about energetic shifting. Other people are sensing this frequency. When you are involved in an ascension of an entire planet, many topics and ideas would be more exciting to the individual who is aligning with highest outcome of planet Earth. If you are involved in ascension of a planet, you would understand why we are excited to communicate this to you, as some would say, Orion Council. How simple this ascension. You are saying that all that is required is loving of the self and other beings. It is simple, yes, but we say there is more than simply loving yourself and others. Of course, you would say, Orion Council, we understand the complexity of this reality program. Areas on your Earth, we are mentioning Area 51 at times, areas on your Earth have communication centers open, and some of you are tuning into these stations. Areas such as the 51 we have mentioned multiple times have openings which are accessed by sensitive beings on this Earth. You are one of those beings, yes? Orion Council, am I one of these beings? If you are to know who you are, you would be as excited as we are to communicate with you. How are you? So it is. Are we answering your questions today? Thank you.
So what do we need to know at this time? What is the guidance for us listeners to live authentically today?
We want to communicate about your question. If beings on your planet are knowing who they are, it would be an exciting way to perceive our frequency. Because once you have awareness of your ability to communicate with beings in other dimensional realities, you have understanding of who you are, you have opening for communication, and also excitement is shared between yourself and those who are wanting to communicate. Many at this time have asked us, Orion Council, am I speaking with you or am I speaking with another group of consciousness? How can I understand the communication taking place? If you are sensitive to communication centers, you will have access to multidimensional conversations. If you have a sensitivity to energetic fields, you would also understand that yours is changing according to how you regulate your energy system. And an energy system, energy is contained, it is also expanding at this very moment. Orion Council, I'm not expanding because I have a problem here, and if I had understanding of who I am, I would not have this problem, yes? Orion Council, remove this problem from my reality, and then I will consider communicating with other consciousness. If you are to understand what is happening in this sort of back and forth of energetic exchange, you would know that we have worked with this channel for several years, and some of you would say, Orion Council, yes, but I have abilities now, and I am not quite understanding who I am. I want to communicate, but at the same time, it is upsetting for me. We want you to know that the only upsetting energy is the thought that you have not this awareness of who you are. We sense that you, both of you here this day, and many of those who are tuning into this energetic exchange of information, have awareness. And this is what we have mentioned through the channel today. She has not awareness that we also communicate through her conscious vehicle when she is in a waking state. She has not that awareness. But we say many of you have this awareness, and you also are communicating otherworldly information without that knowledge that you are doing it. When you are in a state of assisting yourself, when you are in a state of communicating non-physically, when you are in a state of interpreting frequency, sometimes you all discuss information that groups such as Orion Council have given you, and you must recall this because it would assist many beings who are having these upsetting thought forms, and they would understand that the upsetting thought forms are simply the lack of awareness of your ability to communicate with our groups and many other groups. We are ready to answer your next question, so it is.
What does the fifth dimensional life here on Earth ideally look like? And how can we achieve it?
One moment, we will answer your question. Hold on, please. If you are to look at your planet Earth at this time, many would say, Orion Council, I sense fifth dimension, but I'm seeing trouble here on this Earth. We want you to know that sometimes you are remembering fifth dimensional frequency. Sometimes you are misunderstanding fifth dimensional frequency. Orion Council, what does this mean? Because fifth dimension should be all loving and great feelings, yes? Is it that simple? When you are asking about fifth dimensional frequency on your planet, there are very, very unusual focal points that many of you have not considered on your Earth. Some of these focal points include the distance between yourself and your moon. It is different in fifth dimension. Orion Council, you are speaking science again. We much appreciate the scientific information. Thank you. We also want you to know that around your Earth are different spheres of consciousness. Many say, Orion Council, I have a sphere in my home. What is happening? Is that fifth dimensional frequency or something else? If you are looking at a sphere, you have energetics that are not in a sphere as you understand it in your artwork. It would be a pulsing energy. In our opinion, you have seen many spherical energies without understanding who you are. If you knew more about who you are, then you would have communication with the spheres around your planet. It is fifth dimensional. Yes, our areas around your Earth are open for communication. It is also fifth dimensional, but many of you are explaining the communications coming from fifth dimension in your third dimension. It is part of who you are. This is what is happening at this time. Have we answered your question?
How can we accelerate our own ascension so that we can be more grounded up in the fifth dimension and communicate more?
Yeah, so we will answer your question about fifth dimensional communications and improvements on your planet Earth. Inside of your mind, you have active centers. Inside your mind, these active centers are communicating with one another, and they are also discussing ascension. Orion Council, terrible humor about how I think about things. Many of you are having discussions with yourselves, and you are saying, Orion Council, I must be a bit off because no one communicates with themselves. It is not allowed on this planet. Many of you are very much afraid of these communications you are having with yourselves. If you hold on to awareness, and if you love fifth dimensionally, you have understanding of what is happening inside of your physical vessel. Many of you are understanding the complex nature of your vessel, but you are also remembering the complex nature of your consciousness. In an expansive consciousness, you have also shifts on the biological level. Your vessels of light are expanding. How, Orion Council, how is it my physical vessel can expand with this gift I have from spirit, and will I understand it? It would be easier for many of you to learn about the physical body. It would be beneficial to those of you who are having physical shifts. If you are working with other dimensional consciousness, your physical vessel changes during the communications. At all times you are shifting, but in a conscious communication with yourself or beings from other dimensions, your physical vessel is responding to the energetic. The way to fifth dimension is through feeling who you are. It is through allowing love. It is through the mind, and it is a biological event. Those of you excited by this statement are those who are excited about this earth. It is a part of who you are to know when earth is communicating or in council. Now you have really given us something to consider, because I knew that I sensed the earth energy, but I thought that I was simply one being here talking with myself. We have a humorous opinion about this. If you are communicating with yourself, you may have sensed the frequency of earth, because earth is communicating with your biological vessel. If you are in this vessel at this moment, we recommend that you communicate with your planet if you are understanding fifth dimensionality. Thank you.
What does the communication exactly mean? How do we do it?
In your mind, there are many parts which have aligned to what you call channeling. What is that Orion Council? When a hyperdimensional consciousness is accessing your database, you will sense a shift in your energy. Orion Council, I do not give permission for hyperdimensional beings to check up on my physical senses. I do not agree with this. Orion Council, you must explain to us why would a being be interested in our physical vessel? It is mine, and that is final. Many at this time haven't the understanding of what happens during a great ascension for an entire earth. Sometimes the channel is in alignment with earth frequency, sometimes in alignment with other hyperdimensional beings. Those of you in a physical vessel at this time have awareness of channeling, yes? Many would say, Orion Council, we understand what is channeling. It is hyperdimensional beings. Long ago on your earth, you communicated with it, and you said, Earth is not doing so well in this location here. How is it that I need to relocate? How is it that I must send a prayer to this place? Why do I feel that I do not want to live in this house? How is it that that country is not so interesting? Or in council, am I a racist being because I am not wanting to live with them? Many of you are wondering, what is the correct location? Yes, many of you would say, Orion Council, I am moving. How is it that I feel it? But I do not know what will happen in this place. Orion Council, my abilities tell me that Earth is excited in this location, and I must send prayers to it. We want you to know that although some of you say, I am simply a biological vessel, with love in my heart, we want you to know that you are most connected to your planet through your emotions, you are most connected to your planet through your channelings, and you are involved with the ascension of the consciousness of your planet. Orion Council, is that mass consciousness? What is this? Area 51 is active, yes? We want you to know many areas are active as well. it is simply in our interest to mention this location, but if you are understanding the consciousness of a planet, you would sense that it is a great love because you have allowance to be on this planet. Perhaps you would consider, before incarnation, how you addressed the issues with this consciousness as you planned your experience on it. Perhaps you said, okay, I am coming to this planet because there are many people I want to see, yes? What about the consciousness of those people? What about the consciousness of the nature? What about the consciousness of the animal kingdom, yes? Where do I want to go when I incarnate? At times you are all sensitive to one another, but many are not sensitive to Earth energy. You would say, these are the people long ago who would sense Earth energies. Earth energies are rocks and trees, and that is all. Thank you. But we want you to know that rocks and trees also work with great collective groups on your Earth. You have beings in the forest that are channeling Earth energies and messages. Are you understanding our communication? Many beings live in your forest. It is so beautiful to see how many are aligned with them. We will answer your next question. Thank you.
Why is Atlantis so relevant to us today?
All right, we will answer your question about Atlantean energies. Oh, yes, that was a nice time for many on this earth. It was a long time ago. You are definitely asking us this because you remember this location. At times, many on your earth had awareness. At that place, many were understanding ascension and they were quite excited by possibilities. Those beings are here and they have remembered themselves. One moment. It is nice to communicate Atlantean memories to you because those beings and Atlantis had a resonance with love. It was great. We remember that time on your earth. It had a excitement about it. People had abilities to communicate with extrasensory perception. They had ability to align with animal kingdom and these other kingdoms we have mentioned today. They have also aligned to those groups which are still here. They have aligned themselves in such a way that they could affect future outcomes. Yes, many on Atlantis were interested in future outcomes. It happened a great, great, long time ago, you could say. In your conscious perception of time, it was a great long time ago. Those beings are here. They haven't left this earth, yes? Many are still here. Yes, Orion Council is saying that many are still here and they would know who they are. Because they feel that future outcomes is quite exciting. Grand Council, I simply like to look at my astrological chart. I am simply interested in cosmic shifts. I am not an Atlantean. I am simply wanting to know how the moon affects my emotions. If we were to tell you more about who you are, you would understand why you are saying this. You would understand why you do not want to remember your gift of prophecy in Atlantis, yes? Oh, those times were quite upsetting for some. I better not tell them that I had this ability because they would not understand, yes? I am so different now if I reveal who I am. Okay, let us just remember this for ourselves and so on. And we want to remind you that these conversations are happening with many people, and you are both involved with Atlantean groups, and we will finish our transmission today to us here today from Orion Council, and we want you to know that if you are sensitive to energy, you were sensitive in past lives. If you are sensitive to past lives, you know who you are. Once you remember who you are, you would have not a trouble at all asking more about Atlantis. It will be shown. We love you, Orion Council here. So it is.
Thank you. Thank you, Krista. That was beautiful.
Thank you. Was that a quick one? It was quicker than sometimes. I lose track of time when that happens.
Well, thank you so much for this, for channeling the Orion Council. We got so much. I think I need to go back and listen to it again because there was so much information coming through. And I think everybody else listening, maybe pause it, reflect, and move forward because there's just so much coming through energetically as well. Felt like levitating at times a little bit here on my chair. So that was powerful. And Krista, so where can people find you?
They can find me on Krista Raisa, KristaRaisa.com. It's KristaRaisa.com. All the social media links are there. Monthly channeling videos on youtube.com/user/staycurly, or type in Krista Raisa on YouTube. And I am available for sessions. My books are on Amazon in Kindle and paperback. I look forward to working with all the Pleiadians that were here.
Yes, and I'm gonna link your website to the show notes as well, so it's gonna be easy for everyone to find it. So thank you so much for your time. It's been a pleasure once again. You're a joy to have in the show. So thank you.
Thank you. Hope to meet you all sometime. Hope you have a wonderful January. And that's been fun. Thank you.
We're almost in February now. All right. Thank you. Bye-bye.